side of the castle. Now, that's a long trek. They're tired. The morale is low. Bonnie Prince Charlie thinks to prevent a mutiny, a good thing to do to boost the morale is to win back the home of their ancestors, the Stuart Stirling Castle. It's very symbolic. What the Jacobites don't realise is this. In 1746, the castle was strongly garrisoned by the Redcoat Army of General Blakeney. So it's 1746, just try and imagine the Redcoats scurrying around there. Down below, the Jacobites fire a salvo of guns, completely miss the enemy, and they hit the buildings. So they vandalise their ancestors' legacy. The last siege of 1746, a failure for the Jacobites. But the whole of Britain is under siege. Around about 1800, Napoleon Bonaparte of France, and we remember from our school days that Napoleon had a very strange, unusual hobby. He collected countries. He wanted this one for his empire. So back in 1800, the time of Arthur Wells and the Duke of Wellington, two military buildings from the reign of King George III, the building to the right with the green door, was the command post. It's known as the Fort Major's House.